Hi, welcome to my automotive show, KG Canadian Enthusiast. Before start the show, I want to hit the like button and subscribe to my show. Now let's get started. Today on the show, we're going to talk about major brand new vehicles and certainly about electric EV vehicles as well. So now let's get started, people. I want to start with the easy news first. That's my main idea. So let's start with the rumors now. Chrysler has announced that the Chrysler 300 will remain in production for the 2022 model year. So expect to see the Chrysler 300 getting updates and changes in the foreseeable future. More trim levels, because the 300 lost major trim levels, and let's hope the Chrysler 300 does get the important trim levels. Let's hope that's the case. Moving on from that, Land Rover has confirmed that the Land Rover Defender will get a long wheelbase Defender 130 and ultra luxury model of the Defender to compete against its own Range Rover. Think of the upcoming Defender Ultra Luxury as something that's equivalent to the Mercedes-Benz G-Wagon, something that's equivalent to that. So how do I feel about that? I personally feel that's okay. If Mercedes-Benz can sell a body-on-frame G-Wagon, I don't see why Land Rover should not sell the Defender as a Range Rover competitor, but not to be the Range Rover. Obviously less posh than the Range Rover, but it's going to be fairly good. That's my case on that. So overall, I'm expecting on that. Now, they had also talked about having a smaller Defender 80, but that's cancelled because there's no need for something smaller than that. And for there are many people who have been saying it's wrong, it's not right. That is the reality. The Defender is the Mercedes-Benz G-Wagon. That's what it is. People have to accept that, and sales are proving that. The consumer is never wrong if they're buying. That's the fact. Moving on from that, Mazda have facelifted the Mazda CX-5. As you all know, the CX-5 updates include updated styling, more standard equipment, and trim levels have been majorly reshuffled as we are speaking. 5-door SUV, 5 seats, 4, and they only come with all-wheel drive, so no front-wheel drive models anymore, since no one is practically buying front-wheel drive anyway. 6-speed automatic. Now trim levels: Sport, Touring, Grand Touring, and Grand Touring. Now the signature, now there's a middle trim has been replaced with a new trim called the Turbo Trim, which is available, and the Range Shopping Signature Trim. Now I see the interior of the Mazda, and I must admit, it's so ultra luxurious, so luxurious, so comfortable. It's like Mazda is now approaching near luxury standard. That's what Mazda is heading. Near luxury standards, that's a very good thing from Mazda. And with the rear wheel drive Mazda models coming in the future, I think it makes absolute sense that they are doing that indeed. So prices, well, engines are unchanged, 2.5-liter 4-cylinder, 187 horsepower, or the turbocharged engine with 250 horsepower. So you can't really go wrong either of these engines. I personally think go for the most expensive. If you want to experience a true experience on the CX-5's high-end luxury and good performance, go for the CX-5 with a turbo. Question is it better than the RAV4? My answer is yes, but the sales might not say that. But for me, the CX-5 is now better than the RAV4. So let's hope the RAV4 comes with a facelift. So moving on from that, VW have now given the GTX version of the VW ID.4 for the North American market. I'm joking. It's not called the GTX. It's called the Pro S. Now the Pro S is very weird. I find this annoying with VW. You don't get the RT on R, you don't get those models. Now you get the Golf R and the Golf GTI because they have to, otherwise they can't sell the Golf in North America, obviously. So now let's talk about specs of the Pro S ID.4. It's powered by twin electric motors and 295 horsepower and 199 miles per hour top speed. It's electronically limited, that's the top speed. It's same for the entry-level single electric motor model with 201 horsepower as well. Now, I think this solves the performance problem that the ID.4 had. Many people bought the Tesla Model Y because of performance, but this might help the problem. Yes, you lose 10 miles of range, but you have to forgive that. If you are getting more performance, you're going to lose range. The range is expected around 250 kilometers, 250 miles, 260 miles. That's the range, which is good. And considering this competes against the internal combustion compact SUVs rather than the Teslas. Again, Tesla really doesn't have a compare to compete against. Prices will start from $44,000 to all the way to $49,000, which I think a very reasonable price indeed. So moving on. Now let's talk about upcoming Lexus models for a second, all right? The upcoming Lexus RZ450e, which is, for me, it's a full electric Lexus NX sized mid-size SUV, a mid-size luxury. That's what it is for me. Expect to see coming in 2023 or maybe 2025. Wait, that is my timeline for the RZ450e. I would be excited to see what it is going to be. Now, I see the renderings and the pictures. I'm pretty excited on what is about to come. Then, of course, the Lexus TX, which is presumably, for me, it's a large Lexus RX. Nothing more than that, but that's a very good thing. It's going to be most likely based on the Toyota Grand Highlander. Again, that's a good thing. Again, unquestionably. Then, the Lexus LX, we know what the LX is going to be, so I'm not going to even bother telling you. Again, it's going to come next year because of the chip shortage. And then, of course, not least but not last, the Lexus GX. Fun fact, now there is rumors that there's a GX550. That's very exciting. Now, it doesn't mean 550 horsepower. It means it has the engine from the Land Cruiser, which means a twin-turbo V6 with 409 horsepower. I'm looking forward to see, but the GX will come into production, the next generation GX, in 2023 or 2024. That is my timeline for the GX, considering they just updated the new current GX anyway. So, pretty much on that thing, I think it's good to see that Lexus are coming new models. Looking forward to them. Moving on from that, for the last two vehicles on the show, the Ford Fiesta has now been facelifted and updated, of course. Updated styling, more standard equipment, and of course, an easier engine range to understand. So let's talk about specs. 5-door hatch, front wheel drive, 6-speed manual gearbox, a 7-speed DCT. Trim levels, Trend, Titanium, ST Line, Vignale, and ST. Now there's also a Fiesta Active. Now Fiesta Active is actually sort of a lifted up subcompact luxury SUV. That's what it really is. I don't see a purpose of that. I really don't, but hey, it exists. Also, now engine wise, you can't have a diesel option. So the engine options are 1-liter 3-cylinder mild hybrid EcoBoost engines with 123 horsepower and 153 horsepower, and there's entry level 99 horsepower engine as well. The ST is powered by the same 1.5, but it makes a 40 feet of more torque, so it's a more torqueier engine. So that's very good as well. Otherwise, performance numbers are the same, 197 horsepower and 143 miles per hour. Prices wise, expect the Ford Fiesta to start from £16,000 to all the way in my book around £28,000 of the ST. Now, there are many versions of Fiesta, of course. The Fiesta van, there is a Fiesta van as well. So expect, I didn't talk about that because I'm not a big van fan with the Fiesta. I'd rather talk about a real van, so you get my point on that. So moving on from that, let's talk about the Citroen C3. Now, for the Indian market, Citroen has built an Indian spec Citroen C3, which will be sold, in my case, as a subcompact SUV. Its arch competitors will be the Nissan Magnet and the Renault Kiger. And the Nissan Magnet will be its arch competitors. 5-door SUV, front wheel drive, 6-speed manual gearbox, or 6-speed auto. Engines, expect the 1.2-liter engine with 3-cylinder turbo with 110 horsepower, which is not bad really. That's more than the Kiger and the Magnet indeed. Prices, I can't tell you because Indian currency versus dollars is a weird pricing. I would think it will start on $14,000 all the way down to 20 most likely. So moving on from that now the smallest SUV you can buy is subcompact SUVs, right? Wrong, you can go smaller. They are called micro SUVs. They are technically luxury city cars with race ground clearance. Now, you have been able to buy them, things like the Suzuki Agnes, the upcoming Tata Punch, things like that. Now, Hyundai, I've entered the segment with the Hyundai Casper. I've seen the exterior of it. It's absolutely cute and very beautiful looking indeed. Specs, 5-door SUV, 5 seats, front wheel drive, 4-speed auto, trim level, smart, modern, and inspiration. Engines are the same as Hyundai i10, 1-liter 3-cylinder engine, 70 horsepower to a turbocharged 100 horsepower engine. Prices wise, will start from $12,000 to all the way to $16,000 of the inspiration. It has wonderful flexibility on the inside, unquestionably. So again, no surprises. So thank you very much for joining me on this show. Thank you very much. Subscribe and like my show. Thank you very much.